Well,
okay, so Gator, here's the thing about the Masters. We can talk about the golf, and you know, people want to 248-539-9797. But the most fascinating thing of the Masters is who won it. And it's Patrick Reed. Now, I don't expect everybody to remember everything that has ever said on the show. Some of you perhaps have remembered me saying that Patrick Reed is my favorite golfer. Why is Patrick Reed my favorite golfer? Well, because I don't get to watch a ton of PGA Tour golf. I know some of you watch more, but I've always been a fan of the Ryder Cup. And Patrick Reed at the Ryder Cup is awesome. He wins. He gets into it with the fans when they're in Europe, when they're on their territory. He makes unbelievable shots. He is emotional. And he earned the nickname Captain America. And I watched him, and I'm like, this guy is awesome. And he seems to constantly be dropping F-bombs and pumping his fist and running around and almost kind of like a linebacker after a big hit type of guy on the golf course. And yet he looks like, you know, this pudgy little out of shape guy. But at the end of the day, I loved Patrick Reed in the Ryder Cup and became a Patrick Reed fan as sort of a rudderless PGA Tour fan. I didn't have a golfer that I was like, God, I love Jordan Spieth or I love Jason Day or whomever. I mean, I knew who these guys were, and some of them are likable, but nobody that I really got into. I got into Ryder Cup Patrick Reed. And then as time goes by, and you start hearing stories, the backstories of Patrick Reed. And I think the first time I became aware of the fact that he was unpopular, and I remember you and I talking about this on the air a few years ago, ESPN did an anonymous PGA Tour golfer survey. And one of the questions was, there's a fight going on in the player's parking lot. Who is the player you'd least likely go help? And the winner with 23% of the vote was Bubba Watson, but finishing in second with 11% of the vote was Patrick Reed. I'm like, huh, what's wrong with my boy?
What's wrong with Bubba?
Like, you know, I don't know what the problem is with Bubba, but sometimes I watch Bubba and I can... Bubba's got that
Bubba said
smarmy. He's got that smarmy look, but whatever. So that's what, but as time goes by, I realize that Patrick Reed is like the Eric Ebron of golfers. His personality is part of the problem and the unforgivable sins. In golf, the biggest unforgivable sin he was accused of as a freshman in Georgia, cheating. He hit a ball a mile out of bounds. He's playing in a qualifier with his teammates from Georgia, and he walks up and says, oh, here's my ball. And they're like, that's not your ball. And there's a confrontation. And then, oh, by the way, in the locker room, some stuff came up missing. He shows up with a wad of cash the next day, and they think it's him that stole it. Whether he got suspended or quit from Georgia isn't the story, but he left Georgia. And with that as part of the reason why.
Well, yeah, it's alcohol issues there, too.
Like a lot of college freshmen, yes. But I think what got him kicked off the team wasn't the getting the public intoxication. It was the cheating slash stealing from teammates, which can get you in a lot of trouble with teammates. So he transfers to Augusta State. Yes, Augusta, Georgia State University in Augusta, where the Masters is played. And he wins two national championships there, the second of which comes against Georgia and his old teammates. He goes pro, and, you know, there's apparently the golf crowd has become fully aware of his personality flaws. Like, he falls in love with a girl who's 26. He's 22. They decide to get married. Patrick Reed's family is like, we don't know if we approve of this. And so he gets married and doesn't invite his family to the wedding and hasn't talked to his parents since 2012. Now, they were hoping to sort of extend an olive branch. They show up at the U.S. Open in 2014. His wife is in the gallery, whether it was wife or him, who complained. Next thing you know, his parents are being let off the course by police.
Do you know that the parents are trying to extend an olive branch? Or
that's what they say.
Okay.
That's what they say. And this is a guy who's from Augusta State, right there in Georgia, in the shadows of Augusta National, where the Masters is played.
He's from Texas, but yeah.
Yes, he played at Augusta State. You would think he would be like the most popular winner in a long time. Kind of a claimed hometown boy. And they say this was the most lukewarm response ever because people think he's a giant DB. And, you know, I have an acquaintance that was in a U.S. Open locker room who said he was aloof and off at his own and the players would talk and he wasn't involved at all. And You know, I sent a golf friend I know hey, my boy Patrick Reed, and he sent me back the emoji with the face puking. Like, people don't like this guy. And it sounds like one of these people that the whole world, he feels like the whole world's against him and probably doesn't realize that he's the problem. You know what I mean?
Well, I mean, that's harsh.
That's what
I mean,
sounds like to
okay,
me.
Okay, but here's what we don't know. We have no idea what the relationship is with him and his family, okay? We don't know that what was said. You know, sometimes you say things and you can't take them back and they cross a line and people are just, you know what, I'm done with it. Forget it. Okay, I think we've all had moments where we felt like that. Some people get over it and they'll reconcile, and some people don't. And they'll hold grudges, and they'll hold grudges for a long time. I don't know what that relationship is with his parents and his family. So if he's decided that he's had enough and his family is now his wife and his brother-in-law and whatever they decide to bring up, and then so be it. That's his decision to make. You know, we as onlookers can't force our own morality on what he's going to do because we don't know what his story is. Now, this other stuff about him in college and the cheating and all that, yeah, you get off on the wrong foot. And he's also gone on record and said that, you know what, my coach at Augusta State talked to me about that and set me on the straight and narrow. And it was quite a learning experience. And I've been a different person basically since 2014. He's brash. He's confident. And he's awkward. It may just be as simple as he's socially awkward. Now, I did watch at the end of the round yesterday after he won, and he's walking off, and people are, you know, giving him high fives and stuff, and he's with his wife, and waiting for him was Ricky Fowler. Ricky had a big smile on his face and greeted Patrick Reed. They had an embrace, exchanged high fives, and both smiled and talked to each other for a half a second. The cameras went off him, so I don't know how long they were there talking to each other, but it was kind of cool to see. Ricky Fowler is maybe the most likable guy in golf. And there he is out there to congratulate Patrick Reed, who to this point might be the most unlikable guy in golf. But that'll change over time. The more this guy wins, the more he gets in front of cameras and talks to people, and you get to know his personality a little bit more.
Wow. I mean, I think you're giving him a huge benefit of the doubt here. And the thing is, I rooted for him yesterday, and he's still my guy. He's still the guy that I root for. But
what's the benefit of the doubt I'm giving him? Because I think that...
Well, the whole family thing.
Well, yeah,
here's why. Here's
bad
why.
Family.
When the George... Did he have problems with his teammates in Georgia?
Yeah.
Did he have problems... Does he apparently have problems in the PGA locker room?
Maybe.
Okay. When he gets voted the second guy that they're not going to... They're helping to fight. When
yeah, his, they when also... He's got, and the number one guy was family. Bubba Watson. The Bubba Watson seems like he's fine.
Well, he's got an estranged family. The patrons didn't like him yesterday at Augusta. So,
no, because patrons like Rory, and they don't like Patrick Reed. It's fine to not like the guy. It takes time for people to like somebody too. Sometimes
it might be, but that's why when I say if the whole world doesn't like you, I don't know that he should be pointing fingers, and he's not. But I'm saying he might want to look in the mirror and say maybe I'm the problem. Now I also kind of believe that he feeds off all this. I think he's the kind of guy that feeds off me against the world, and maybe that's why he's created that. But, you know, I think there's a lot of evidence there that his personality rubs people the wrong way.
Well, he's a weird dude. I said yesterday at some point that, you know, he has to, before he goes to bed at night, he has to make sure that every door in the house is closed.
Yeah.
Okay, so he's got his own peccadilloes, and he may just be a weird guy that's, like I said, socially awkward. But as far as the family goes, can't judge him.
Hold on, hold on. I'm not judging him for the family.
I'm saying this to everybody out here.
Okay.
You can't judge him for things that you don't know what goes on with his family. Okay? We have no idea other than, well, his parents apparently didn't like his wife and that they had a reservation about him getting married. He got married anyway. I'm sure it goes a hell of a lot deeper than that, and we'll never know, and it's not – we have no right to know.
I guess I'm just saying, though, it's not just the family. It's Georgia, the PGA locker room, his family – You know that the patrons at Augusta, Nike didn't even have him on their website yesterday, and he is a Nike golfer. Like, he wears their gear, and they were like, we better put a picture up on him. So, of him, I'm taking all this into consideration, because do I know Patrick Reed personally? No. But it sounds as though he's got some problems with people. Now, if that makes him the best golfer he can be, so be it. 248-539-9797.